Where do I start?
Why don't you tell me how the hell you got Harvey to hire you in the first place?
Fire up that laptop and I'll show you. Ask me anything there is to know about the law.
That's how you did it. You beat him? Well, I'm not Harvey. I don't need a computer.
Harvey Specter, I represent Mike Ross.
Sir, you can't go back there, sir.
Well, hey there. Are you charging him?
Not at the moment.
Then he's coming with me. You had no right to bring him in.
I had every right to bring him in, but it doesn't matter because he came in voluntarily.
And he's leaving immediately.
We were just having a friendly conversation about the witnesses who suddenly fell out of the Ava Hessington case. Seems your associate was a little chummy with the associate at Grant Gould. Harvey Gunderson, I think is his name.
Harold Gunderson.
You're right. You're Harvey. I gotta keep this all straight in my head before I make my case. Because once we bring Harold in, he'll point the finger at Mike, who'll then have no choice but to bring it right home to you, Harvey.
So what's the problem?
The problem is, I left him that message 3 nights ago, and he hasn't said anything. I don't know what to do.
Well, when a person gets a message like that and they act like they didn't, it's one of two things. Either they got the message and they don't feel the same way, or they didn't get the message. And who doesn't get their messages?
He made his choice.
About the fact that Mike Ross is all of a sudden representing himself, because it means Harvey thinks he's gonna lose. Harvey's never given up control of a case in his life. And if he's doing that now, it means he wants that loss on Mike's record. Bullshit, I read the transcript backwards and forwards. He thinks he's gonna lose.
But I am telling you, Harvey letting Mike take the reins is not him giving up. It's him growing up and realizing he is not the one to bring this home.
Do you want to talk about it?
Talk about what?
Well, I don't know. Maybe the fact that Mike is working on a closing to keep himself out of jail, and you're not working on it with him?
There's nothing for me to do, Donna. It's in his hands.
Jessica, I have some dire news. I was just walking by the conference room, and I saw Max Pollard sitting there all by himself.
Harvey was a no-show?
Don't worry. I took care of everything. But it's not like Harvey to miss a meeting.
Thank you, Lewis. I'll look into it.
You see, that's just it. I think something might be wrong with him.
You mean like he's a spy?
No. Jessica, listen. Ever since my heart attack, I've been worrying about other people's health. And I'd ask Donna, but I don't want to burden her with the knowledge of his mortality.
You don't think Donna knows Harvey can die?
Look, Jessica, I know Harvey appears to be lean and relatively fit, but coronary disease can strike even the most handsome.
Lewis, listen to me. Harvey isn't sick. He didn't have a heart attack. And if he missed that meeting, I'm sure there's a reasonable explanation.
I'm sure you're right. I want to go check my blood pressure.
Good idea.